Yes, class. Yesterday we were reading our lesson, The Toy Box. Just have a preview of the previous pages that we have done. As we studied there, there were two kids of the family. One is boy whose name is Tom. On shifting the new house, the boy had some uneasy feeling and he was just hearing some type of sounds, and when the other people of the house they reached there, they didn't listen any sound, so all were embarrassed by the attitude of the boy. So on that page we will see here, the boy again listened the sound, and always when he listened the sound he just shouted and the sounds just disappeared. But at that moment he decided not to give any sound and he just kept silent. He just kept silent, he went out of the room and called his mother and his sister. So look here, we will start the lesson from here now. It's part 2 of the lesson. I found mother and Matilda baking a cake in the kitchen. Hurry! Come with me, I urged, but don't say a word or make a sound. Looking puzzled, they followed me to the playroom. With my finger over my lips, I tiptoed across the floor towards the box. They followed closely and silently. As we approached the box, there was a cry and then some mumbling, an adult voice saying something. A further cry followed finally by my scream, which I had controlled till then but now could hold back no longer. We stood there for a moment, breathing softly, listening intently, but heard nothing more. So when the boy decided to not make out any sound, he just came out of the room, called his mother and sister, and when they came, they again just listened and there was a cry and there was some other sound. And at that moment, the boy could not help him to shout, to cry. So the sound again suddenly disappeared at the moment. Father entered the room at a gallop. What's going on here? He asked abruptly. What has happened? His words are not completed because the other family members, they paused him. He paused in a mid-flow, noticing us standing in silence, mother indicating with one finger to her lips for him to be quiet. So the father, who was coming in the room and he was asking that what's going on, he was asked to keep quiet by the signals. Mother asked him to keep quiet, just to listen what's going on here. So just he kept quiet. We left the room and proceeded in an orderly fashion to the living room, where mother explained what had happened. Now they left that playroom. They came in the living room and the mother is now telling to the father everything that had happened in that room. Well, you wait here, said father when he had heard the story. I will investigate. Father marched out of the room purposefully. After a moment, we heard the box being dragged over the wooden floorboards in the playroom. After a while, father joined us again. He did something in that playroom and then came back to them. Come with me, he said, going towards his golf bag in the hall. I think it's high time we have a good look at the old storerooms and coal bunker at the side of the house. I found an air vent in the wall hidden behind the toy box. We shall find out where it goes, and just in case, I'm taking the golf club. So what happened when the father went into the room? He just take a sight of that toy box, and there he found a hole and air vent there in the room. So he asked all the family members to come and get there to see there would be a storeroom or coal bunker there. So they went there to investigate, to explore more rooms of the house. Still, these rooms were unexplored. So now they are going there, and as the father was cautious, so he takes some stick with him also. That was golf stick. Father selected a three iron and led the way, swinging in it in the air. We crunched over the gravel, passed through a narrow gap in the thick hedge surrounding the side garden, and approached the part of the house adjacent to the playroom. There were hundreds of the broken tiles, old doors and window frames, a rusting bicycle and other unwanted and broken pieces of the furniture piled against the wall and scattered over that part of the garden. So they reached a particular place where they can enter the storeroom, and here is the description. What was that place looking like? "We shall have to get all this rubbish removed," said father, picking his way through the debris. "All this must have been cleared out of the house when it was renovated. What a mess." We could see two windows low down on the wall and some steps leading down to what looked like a cellar door. The path to the door was clear, so it was obvious that someone has used the doorway quite recently. Now they explored the way to a storeroom. Father clambered down the few steps to the door. Mother, Matilda, and I stood at the top, wondering what he would do. Father rapped on the door with his golf club and called out, "Hello, is anybody there?" There was no answer. He rattled the rusty doorknob and struck the door again with his club. Then he turned the knob and the door creaked open. The light from the open door and the windows on either side of it filtered into the room. There was some movement inside, and father stood back with his club raised. We could hear a tearful woman's voice. Now what they explored there, there was a door of a storeroom. The father just tried to struck the door very hardly, but there was no sound now. Then he opened the door by himself, and by carefully he also hold his stick in his hand. So there, what they saw there was a strange scene. There was a woman, there was a tearful woman, and what she was saying, "Please sir, we don't mean any harm," sobbed the woman. "Who are you and what are you doing here?" demanded father. "We have nowhere to live, sir," explained the woman. "We found this place by chance and moved in for a shelter. We have been living here for some weeks now." "Who is with you?" asked father. "My little child," cries the woman, turning to look towards the cot which stood against the wall behind her. "She is not well, sir, because of the damp. She cries a lot. And my husband Jack has gone to the village to fetch her some medicine." "Well, the mystery of the morning toy box has finally been solved," I thought to myself as we stood there looking sadly at the wretched women. "They will stop complaining about my vivid imagination now." Now the boy is just thinking by himself that now the family members will not blame my imagination, that there was no sound and just I was listening the sound. The mystery was solved. There was a family living in that storeroom because they were very poor and they didn't find any place to take shelter. So by chance they found that place and they entered there. Mother took charge of the situation immediately. 1 month later, the child was gurgling with laughter on the sunny lawn outside the house. The woman, Frances, was employed to help in the house. Her husband, Jack, was given the job of gardener and handyman. The coal bunker and storerooms were cleaned, damp-proofed and painted. The rubbish from the side of the house was removed and shrubs were planted. Everything worked out well for all of us. The spooky house became a warm and comforting home. So this is the ending of the story. The mystery is resolved and the ending of the story is very happy that poor family get a shelter and also work to do, and they started to live happily there.